going to, as promised, the comparison between our two meat chickens.
Yes, and as I mentioned in the weekend video, I was really shocked at how different they were. A couple weeks ago, we did a comparison video, but that was strictly just on raising them and what we thought. So we are comparing the Big Red Broiler, or Freedom Ranger,
yes,
to the Cornish Cross. So just an overview of what we talked about in that video, pros and cons of both. The Big Red Broilers take longer to grow out. They take 3 months to grow out. Don't go through feed quite as fast, but you're raising them for longer.
Yeah.
And they're better foragers. They act like chickens.
Yeah.
They'll scratch and do a little bit more foraging that way. Cornish Cross grows out a lot faster.
Yeah.
Takes 2 months to grow them out. They will eat feed faster, but you're not feeding them for as long. But they don't act like chickens, and they have far less feathers, which is part of just the characteristic of meat chickens.
Yeah.
And visually, we said that, you know, they look like they had bigger breasts on them and everything. So now that we have packaged, weighed, and taste tested, we can give you our thoughts on that.
Yeah. If you happen to hear or see anything going on in the background, John is making tortillas.
Which we did a video on that recently, which I'll link here so you can find it.
Yeah. Based on raising them out, we both really felt like we preferred the Big Red Broiler over the Cornish Cross.
But is that the same now that we've taste tested? So, the weigh-in.
Yeah.
Because that was the first thing that we saw.
Yeah.
Cornish Cross definitely got bigger.
Which is surprising because I thought I had remembered the Big Red Broiler being bigger, but I was wrong.
We're not talking by a lot. I would say, without like really doing an average, the Big Red Broilers average out to be about 6.5 pounds per bird.
Mm-hmm.
These averaged out to be about, I would say, 6¾ pounds. So we're talking pretty close. Most of them are in that 6.5 range, but we had several that were over 7 pounds.
Right.
And one, the heaviest, was even like just over 8 pounds.
Yeah. Cooking the Cornish Cross, the broth was not as rich. I had remembered the Big Red Broilers having more fat on them. That was definitely the case. The Cornish Cross did not have the fat on them, which is probably because they grow out faster and all of that.
Yeah, maybe so.
Because of that, we didn't have that nice, rich, dark broth, and we didn't have nearly as much as we would get from the Big Red Broiler. So for me, having that broth is really important. We use broth in cooking so many of our dishes.
Yeah.
And to flavor other food. It also didn't seem to have the amount of collagen that we would get from our other birds.
Yeah, when it cooled, it wasn't quite as thick. Flavor-wise, I would say that they're not as flavorful.
They aren't.
That was one thing that was very obvious when we first tasted it. It's just, I mean, it does taste like kind of your normal chicken that everybody's used to.
Right.
With a little, like, I would say next level, because it is raised here,
better
food, all of that stuff.
Right.
Aw, Joe brought you flowers.
Thank you, Joe.
It doesn't have quite the richness of the flavor, I would say.
I agree. There's just a lack of depth. The dark meat wasn't as dark.
So the biggest surprise to me, which I have to show you guys, is the bone structure on these things. I was shocked. So these came from pretty average birds on both. This is not in like one extreme and another extreme, like the largest versus the smallest. So let me show you the leg bones. So here's the drumsticks between the two of them. I'll give you 5 seconds to guess which one you think is which. Okay, not 5 seconds. It didn't take that long.
No.
Surprisingly, this is the Cornish Cross. Way smaller legs as far as the length in the leg.
Mm-hmm.
This was the Big Red Broiler. A lot bigger leg, longer leg. There was more meat on the leg.
Yeah.
A noticeable difference in the two.
Yeah.
The other sample is the wing bone. The main bone that comes out of the wing. Again, Big Red Broiler. Cornish Cross. So smaller. The bones on the Cornish Cross are a little bit thicker. So I do wonder how much that plays into the weight.
Maybe. Yeah.
I think that the Cornish Crosses are probably just a bigger bird.
Yeah.
But that was one thing that really surprised me, was the difference in the dark meat. So longer legs, a little bit longer wings on the big red broiler.
Right.
But
the Cornish cross did have more meat on the breast, which if you do a lot of like chicken salad or want to make sandwich meat, that might be beneficial for you.
So the white meat on the Cornish cross, you get a lot more.
Yeah.
On the big red broiler, you get more dark meat.
Yeah.
I mean, as far as just like per bird. So definitely something to think about. The big red broilers still do have a nice size breast, but that's definitely the noticeable trait on
yes.
the Cornish cross.
Yeah.
Some things to consider and things that I was definitely surprised by.
Yeah.
But overall, I would say flavor-wise, hands down, big red broiler.
I agree.
So, if it's not obvious, which one do you prefer?
Big red broiler.
Yeah, same. So we will continue to do big red broilers. Again, they do take a little bit longer to grow out, probably a little bit more expensive because of that. But since we are in a time where it's not, you know, quote unquote, like crunch time or
right.
like
we don't
whatever.
Have to have them quickly.
Exactly. We're going to continue to choose that better quality over a cheaper, faster grow out bird.
But you have to choose what's best for your family and your homestead.
Definitely. Definitely. So thank you guys for joining us. I hope this helps you. If you're considering and looking into meat chickens and trying to figure out, well, should I go with this or this? Hopefully this helps you a little bit in conjunction with that other video that we did a couple weeks ago. So hope you guys continue to have a great week and be blessed.